Hello everyone, today I wanted to share with you some thoughts on the interaction between entities. We've seen in other videos that we can have interaction between entities using things like the component lookups. That's what we used for our tutorial series in making the tower defense and the towers damage our enemies. But if we have a more complex system, like a full-fledged combat system, we may need to have more complex interactions. What we've done in other videos using component lookups is fine if we have a simple interaction from one entity to one entity. But if you want to have more complicated interactions, let's say between multiple entities damaging the same single entity in a single frame, or even multiple entities doing damage to multiple entities, you will reach some limitations and some difficulties just doing that with component lookups. You can still manage some features using dynamic buffers or other data structures. What I wanted to share with you today is a project that was initiated by Philippe Saint-Amand, which covers different ways to interact between entities using different patterns. This project was updated to the latest version of Unity Dots by Godsmile, and I've taken that version to also update it, make it so that we can have a built version to test in real play and not in the editor. I've also added the pattern I used to create my old ability system, available in Git in the description if you're curious. Let's have a look at the project. You can see in the project structure, we have the folder stress test, test events, and inside this folder, we have all the systems for each of the different methods. So if we take a look at method E, for instance, as you can see, all of the systems will work in the same kind of way. We have first a singleton that allows us to enable or disable that particular method of executing and triggering interactions. Then we have the application, or rather the triggering of the interaction, so emitting some kind of events. And then we have the way that we consume those events or apply the interaction, so to actually decrease the health in that case. If we take a look at the job itself, as you can see, we are reading a native stream or stream of event, and we are applying it in this particular example. We are applying it using an interlock method, which is restricted to a simple add or subtract if the value is negative. And all the other methods, all the other ways to do that have a similar layout. If we have a look at the method end, for instance, we have the same kind of pattern. We read first the singleton to make sure that we want to execute this method particularly. And then we have the writing to the stream. Here we have a few additional jobs which are to reorganize the different interactions, to group them by targets basically. And then we have a job to actually apply the effect, and finally some cleanup job. But it's always the same pattern. We first trigger the action or the interaction, and then we apply the effect of the interaction. You can also see that if we look at the test runner, we have all the unit tests that are executed for each of the methods, every time with a different set of attackers and targets, or targets and attackers. And we also have the test report for the performance. So you can have a look at the performance report, where you can see the maximum execution time, median execution time, and minimum execution time for each of the methods of each of the iterations. If we have a look at the built project, we can see here that I have a few selections, a few parameters and settings. For now, everything is initialized at zero state, let's say. So there is no interaction between any entities, and as a baseline, you can see that on my computer, I'm averaging around 2000 FPS. What we can see here in the dropdown is all the different methods that are available to test. So there is some namings convention. Each method is named based on the pattern that it uses. So for instance, the method A uses a parallel stream or write in a native stream in parallel, and then applies the modification or the interaction through pooling of buffers. And as you can see, there are plenty of methods. So you can select one. I will select the first one, for instance. Then you can select the number of targets you have on your environment. So we can go from 0 to 500 thousands. So I will pick a more realistic number around 50,000 targets. And then we have the number of attackers that goes from 0 to 10. And that's the number of attackers per target. So meaning if I go to 10, there will be 500,000 attackers. So let's put something more realistic, like 4. And finally, it's the number of workers. And the number of workers is basically the number of threads you can allocate to the processing of the jobs. So here on my machine, on my computer, since I have 32 threads, I can go from 0 to 31. Let's set it to 31. And if you click on update now, it will initialize everything and use the 50,000 targets and 4 attackers. Obviously, you see we have a drop in the number of FPS. We are averaging at 50-60 FPS. Now the average has caught up. And you can try different methods. So if we take the method B, for instance, you can see that we go from 57 to 63. So it's a bit better, but not much. Let's check if we can have another good method, the method E, which is a bit particular. You can check this. It has much better performance, but it has some limitations because it's using interlock operation. It's really restricted to adding and removing from a single value. It's not very flexible. If we have a look at another method, which is actually the one I used in my own old ability package, you can pick the method N and we check it. We have much less FPS than the previous method, but we are still far better than the two initial ones. So you can have access to this project. I will put the link in the description. You can build it and you can have a look through the code to understand the different patterns and also try out a few scenarios to see which pattern you think would be better for you. For my part, I think I will stick with the N method, so the one I used for my old ability package, because I feel like this is the most flexible and scalable solution across all the methods. Feel free to have a look at the project, check out the different methods and make your own opinion. That's it. That's what I wanted to share with you today. If you like the video, please share and like the video. If you want to support me, there is also a link to a Ko-fi page where you can make a donation. And in the description is also a link to the asset store. If you want to consider buying some assets from the asset store, you can use my affiliate link. And it will help me support the channel without having any cost for you. So thank you everyone. See you in the next video.